Good morning, and a blessed Monday morning to you. When you were a child, did anyone ever ask you the question, "So, what do you want to do when you grow up?" It's an interesting question, and I'm sure there was a lot of pondering that went around that question when you were asked. But I think an even better question is, "So, who do you want to be? Who do you want to be?" Because who we are will affect what it is that we do. As we continue on in our study this morning, today and then for the next two Mondays, we're going to take a look at some models of living out who we are in Christ Jesus. The first model is the Apostle Paul himself. So, we pick up in chapter 2, verse 17. Paul writes this, "But even if I am being poured out as a libation over the sacrifice and the offering of your faith, I am glad and rejoice with all of you. And in the same way, you also must be glad and rejoice with me." Paul is taking a very common image that would have been rooted in the history of the people. It was a common image of what was called a drink offering. People would offer animal sacrifices, and then what they would do is they would have a drink offering. They would pour either water or sometimes even honey, but more typically wine. They would pour it in the front of the altar, and then sometimes on the animal sacrifice itself. It was what was called a drink offering. So what Paul is saying here is that the Philippian church, they were sacrificing for the cause of Christ. They were enduring incredible suffering for the cause of Christ. And what Paul was doing was but just an offering on top of their sacrifice. So it was using this common image in a way to communicate sacrifice, sacrifice. And in the Apostle Paul himself is a perfect example of one who sacrifices, sacrifices for the cause of the Lord Jesus Christ. Sacrifice gives rise to joy. Sacrifice gives rise to joy. You see, when we're so consumed with ourselves, when all we're doing is thinking about ourself, that's the way, that's the path that, well, in the end, it doesn't lead to deep and lasting joy. No, deep and lasting joy is rooted in giving all for the cause of the Lord Jesus Christ. Where the thought, where the focus, where the words, where the actions, it is all in saying, how can I glorify the Lord Jesus? How can I live a life of sacrifice? Sacrificing things, sacrificing oftentimes our own wants and our own desires. How can we live that life of sacrifice to bring glory to the Lord Jesus? Because sacrifice births joy. I think of Hebrews, the 12th chapter. There we read these words. "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely, and let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith." Catch this. "Who for the sake of the joy that was set before him endured the cross, disregarding its shame, and has taken his seat at the right hand of the throne of God." What an incredible phrase there, where it says, "For the sake of the joy that was set before him, endured the cross." sacrifice, births, joy. The Lord Jesus Christ, a wonderful model, of course, of sacrifice, giving his own life for the redemption of the world, being raised and now seated at the very throne of God. And the Apostle Paul, a follower of the Lord Jesus Christ, and a model to us of what it means to live life for others, to live life sacrificing, so that as we serve, God is glorified. The life of sacrifice, giving rise to joy. Let's pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time and your word. Your word is truth. Thank you, Lord, for the call to live our lives for you. And thank you for the truth that sacrifice gives rise to joy. Forgive us, Lord, for those times of selfishness in our lives, when we're consumed with simply ourselves. Forgive us and turn us outward to look upon the needs of others, to sacrifice for them. For in the process, you are glorified. In Jesus' name, amen. May the Lord bless you this week. May you model a life of sacrifice that gives glory to the Lord Jesus Christ. Encourage someone.